production of PBS 39.
Much to Ron's relief, the band members and audiences welcomed him with open arms.
The band and the public were very, very supportive, even in those early years, because they could have been pretty tough, actually.
Ron has a great personality. Everybody likes Ron. I don't think he has any enemies. And no matter where he goes, somebody knows Ron.
According to Ezra, Ron has taken the band to new levels.
And I think the band is the highest caliber it's been, really, since I'm with the band. We play music now that 40, 50 years ago we'd have never attempted.
After retiring from teaching in 1997, Ron traveled to the country of Oman, located on the Arabian Peninsula. He spent 2 weeks there working with the Royal Oman Symphony Orchestra.
She'll be back in touch with him a little later on, okay?
But just because he's retired doesn't mean Ron isn't busy. He's the associate conductor for the Allentown Symphony Orchestra and teaches music at both Muhlenberg and Moravian College. He also enjoys the outdoors and travels often with his wife and college sweetheart, Joan. By the way, she also plays in the band. You'll find her in the French horn section. Ron enjoys leading this band and says every now and then while he's conducting, he can almost feel the history behind him.
You know, most of the time, certainly I'm focused on what's happening with the music and the performance and so on. But I must admit that there are times that you almost think somebody's looking over your shoulder and checking it out, because it's a long, long tradition.
In keeping with tradition, Ron looks forward to the John Philip Sousa concert held every 4th of July in West Park. It's one of the band's biggest annual events.
I just love John Philip Sousa music.
About 3 hours before the concert, crew members arrive to set up the equipment. They haul dozens of instruments and other accessories onto the band shell stage. After about an hour, the musicians begin to arrive. They find their seats and prepare for a last-minute rehearsal. Finally, Ron goes over a few tricky spots in the music. While the band practices, eager fans slowly start trickling in. Before long, more than 4,000 people have gathered for the concert.
Our audience expects to hear traditional American concert band music.
And most of the time, that music comes in the shape of John Philip Sousa. Ron considers Sousa's tunes an essential part of any Independence Day celebration.
If you mention Sousa, people often think of it as being patriotic. And it's usually, quite frankly, happy, for lack of another word. It's upbeat and enjoyable to listen to.
While the audience enjoys the entertainment, the band members say their reward is playing for such a large crowd.
To me, the thrill of playing in the band is the audience reaction.
Nobody can do a march the way a band and it really gets them excited.
When the audience is responsive, it's contagious, and the band actually responds to that.
So what if one of these music lovers wants to play with the Allentown band? Well, getting a seat on this stage isn't an easy process. It starts with an invitation to practice with the band.
And they would come and play for me and then be invited to play rehearsals and performances. And then after a period of 1 year, I'm able to nominate that person to the board for membership.
So you probably think the band's made up of a bunch of professional musicians, right? Well, think again.
Not one of them makes their living by playing that instrument. We have a medical doctor, we have a dentist, we have salespeople, we have people representing all walks of life.
And while the average age for band members sits between 45 and 55 years old, there's always room for the next generation. Just like most 17-year-olds, Lee Adam Walk spends a lot of time studying. But even though he's still in high school, Lee Adam plays his French horn like a true professional. He spends a lot of time trying to perfect the sounds of this elegant instrument, and so far, it's paid off.
He has represented his school in all the honor bands, the district bands and regional bands and so forth, and orchestras.
Those accomplishments led Ron to invite Lee Adam into the Allentown Band a few years ago. But it wasn't his first experience with this group.
Actually, when I was a week old, my mom took me to my first Allentown Band concert.
You see, his dad, Lee Walk, has been a bassoonist with the band since 1968. About 5 years ago, Lee Adam took over as the sign carrier for concerts, but it wasn't long before he was playing music.
I was scared out of my mind, and I can remember the first rehearsal. It was overwhelming. I probably got in 3 notes or something. I was petrified because everything is sight reading, you know.
Now, Lee Adam sits just a few feet away from his father at every concert, continuing a family tradition.
It's better. Yeah, it's nice to know, and it's good to know that he's really contributing, too, that he's not... It's not nepotism that he's in there. He's really holding up his part. It's a thrill.
According to Ron, it's not the age of the musician that matters. It's their talent and dedication.
People come to expect a certain level. And to maintain that level is extremely important. And the people in the band realize that. It's important to them to come away feeling that they've really played a quality performance.
For nearly 2 centuries, the Allentown Band has given audiences the gift of good music, a legacy they're striving to keep alive.
We'll just keep going, you know. We've been going for 175 years. We're not going to stop now.
So as another 4th of July concert winds down, the audience and band members gear up for the number that closes every show, Stars and Stripes Forever.
If you would like a copy of the Allentown Band 175 Years of Musical Memories, we'll send one to you as a thank you gift when you become a member of Lehigh Valley PBS at the $60 level. Just call 610-867-4677 extension 132.